All right. We are here and we are live for the last week of the LHL season, LHL on DGL. I am Winners with the One. I'm here to bring it with you, to you, AIla. Set up here. So, at least we've got a picture, and hopefully you can hear my voice. Yeah, I thought last week was the end of this season for LHL as well as HQML, but it turns out it wasn't. We have a couple more games left in the season, and this first one tonight is going to be Philadelphia versus Boston. It's going to happen before I give you the lineups. Careful. In blue, Philadelphia, Lord Nugget. Neflail, Zam, Gabe, Anguilla, Fleur, in red, Boston, Gloriax, BGP, Gap, Kapanen, PK Paching, and Alfan. Always get the names right or do. And, but yeah, there are still some playoff questions to be answered tonight, Thursday. This is an important game for Philadelphia. And Toronto's got an important game tonight against Edmonton. They are in fourth and fifth place. They are jockeying for that last playoff spot. All these games have some implications. As long as you can see it on the recording, it's all good. It's coming through. It's frozen on the dashboard. I want to make sure that we are bringing you all the live action. Philadelphia takes on Boston. It appears it is working. Wonderful. Love it when a plan comes together. So organized and professional. But yeah, I guess I was lulled into a false sense of security by the All-Star game being last week. I thought that we were bringing you the last games of the season. But no, there's tonight and Thursday night, and then next week we will be bringing you playoff game. All the dust settles, figure out who is playing whom. Right now we know that Boston in red is playing Philadelphia in blue, and no score so far. Very early on, a high-powered Boston team and an explosive Philadelphia team, and a big save by PK Paching. Keep the sheet clean so far. Yeah, we know that Boston likes to turn things around quickly from defense to offense. We'll probably see a lot of that from them here. Philadelphia's had a bit of an edge so far, but here is a chance in front. He's going to have some pursuit, and the double team's going to take him. Medeiros following through, shoots and scores. What a play.
They make it look so easy.
They
but
do.
It's not easy at all.
It's not easy. And Gabe going to tie things up at one. Even you're running a little slow tonight, AIla. I understand. It's been that kind of day. But here to bring you all the action. We've got four games scheduled. Wraparound chance rejected. Now Boston on the move again. BG going to let this one play off the wall and dump it in from the point. Be cleared away. Yeah, just that was a great play by Dial. The double team looked like they got him. That's a lesson for all young hockey players out there. Never give up on a play. Stay with it. Never know what's going to happen. Keep driving. Gabe being Gabe, he is a goal scorer in his own right and has tied this thing up at one. With minute and change left in the first period. Already a good game. Long shot. And Meatsell will get the save twice there. Second attempt. Talk about following up the play. Goes for netminders as well. And have an easy time with this one. Squatting it loose. Zone. Kapanen maybe going for this. No, it is taken away. And Guy Lafleur. Oh, quickly. But again, the defense is there. I believe that was Dauphin. Across the rink, it will be again Dauphin taking it behind his own net. Set up their offense from there, taking their time. Plenty of time left on the clock. 40 seconds. Pushed around. Will they have a chance before time runs out? Here is Kapanen. It is stolen. And a possible chance here for Philadelphia. Lord Nugget going to just hammer one in from the back. Time ticking down. The long pass there. Kyle. Lord Nugget does get it away. End of the first period. So, yeah, the playoffs are at stake. Philadelphia desperately needs a win here, as does Toronto in their game. Oh, did you get kicked, G-Lore? Yeah, they're very serious about that. That's a pretty steadfast rule. If you're not playing in the games, kick people out of the service. That started in Russia, actually. They do that over there, mostly because of ping issues. Causes lag the more people are in. There's already some real issues being in lag in North America on throughout all the servers. I don't know what's going on. It's happening to a collect source servers. It's happening to ours, the Royale with Cheese server. There's a hop in there somewhere that's weird. Trying to do everything they can alleviate. Now, that's one of the things that they've done over the past few seasons. Go watch the streams. And I'm for it because people should be watching the damn streams anyway. Otherwise, right? I could be somewhere in sunny Eastern Europe doing Counter-Strike right now. But dial! Top shelf for Mama Keeps the Cookies. His second of the game. A second for his team. Dauphin on the assist. 2-1. Boston takes the lead. Wow.
I am quite impressed.
I am always quite impressed with this Boston team. They locked up a playoff spot themselves pretty early on, as well as locking up regular season title, if nothing else. They have been an unstoppable force throughout this long campaign. So this was week 9. It's really been 9 weeks. Wow. They've been good throughout. So is the Philadelphia team, and they're trying to fight off Boston again. Offensive attack. It is key to how they do it. But Philadelphia has meat cells. He is key to how they do it. So, puck loose along the boards. It's going to be a battle for it here. It's anybody still. Again, Dial working his way through. And he'll get a shot off the save made in meat cell. Very strong. Drunk. Good like that. Nice pass across, right on. Shot off the post! Oh, and that looked like one that would go across the line. But it does not. Oh, and another! But nothing doing, and now Boston again We'll push this in the other direction. Dial with the shot just wide. Kind of knuckling up on him. So, yeah, playoff fever is in the air. In all of hockey. In the NHL, it is, too. The NHL playoffs about to get underway. Very excited about that. I think this is going to be a fantastic NHL playoff season. It's anybody's take. It really is. It is a wide open league. LHL, maybe not as wide open. You would think that, I mean, if you're betting on this stuff, Vegas, you would probably want to put your money on this Boston team just the way they've carried themselves throughout the regular season. But as we know, as Chris Berman always says, that's why they play the games. Anything can happen. Philadelphia team is staying with them here in this game. And they need a win to stay afloat, keep their playoff hopes alive. This thing I'm looking at here, I don't know if it takes the Sunday games into consideration or not, so I don't know if it's entirely accurate. But I do know that it is a battle between Philadelphia and Toronto for the fourth and final spot of the playoffs. Wins are important tonight and Thursday. Inch down to the end of the second period. Boston still with the lead. Meatsail saw Dial out there all alone and he went right at him. Probably the correct call, as it turned out it was. Dragged him off the play. And keep it to a one-goal deficit for Philadelphia as they take it to the third period. Talk about anybody's game. This one definitely is. This thing on? Okay, great. All right. Setting up the equipment, and then things were like, is this working or not? Right before. Static in the line. New adapter for this microphone, but the cost of doing business, big time casting. Oh, watch the puck float gracefully through the air. A beautiful close up. I do say so myself. And now dumped into the Philadelphia zone. This one's going to bounce out to the faceoff circle, and Philadelphia will clear it out. Maybe no, held in, and a race for it here. And they're going to go ahead and send it down. They've got a chance in front. But again, look how closely the Boston defense is playing them. Everybody's got their man, and they are staying right with them. And positionally very adept. They get in a spot where they can get a stick up and try to block whatever you try to do, whether that be a pass or a shot, and Dial somehow the pass through traffic gets to him. How about that?
Hard to top that.
To top that indeed, yeah. That's how it's drawn up in the books. They saw that coming. Somehow just threading the needle. Burying one. Get a two-goal lead. Down to 3 minutes. Left in regulation of this one. And Boston. This is how they've looked all season. Philadelphia, a crappy team. They will be fighting hard in these final minutes of regulation. Try to get that lead down a bit. But Dial. Oh, man. 4-1. They're saying 3. I don't know. Was there a goalie interference on one of those? I don't know. Dial is just having a good night tonight. We've seen him have good nights like this quite a bit. One of the keys to Boston's success. Oh, the shot just wide. Got a little bit off the blade for him there as he was launching that one. So Philadelphia, they've had their chances, had their moments, but it's been too much dial, too much Deloriex for any team. He's having a night like this. He's getting a lot of help from, this is just good team play from Boston. Good rink awareness that they know where each other are going to be. Passes are on point. Transition game so quick. We've seen it over and over. They are on their way to taking another W here. 1 minute and 30 seconds left. And they control the puck. Corner now is Dalphin. He'll send it in front. Oh! And Dial trying to get another one of those in the slot, but that one just a little behind him. Head. But they do maintain control here, but Zam will nice poke check to get that away. And they will regain it in the neutral zone. Oh, he's looking for the spin move here. Meatsail again with the distraction. We'll prevent that from happening. And the shot, the save, has Sully in the net now. 35 seconds, and DeBeezy's giving me some playoff info. Good, man. I was hoping somebody would do this. Thank you. If Philadelphia loses, Toronto only needs 1 point to eliminate them. So this Toronto game coming up is going to be huge because it is looking like a Philadelphia loss here very much as there are 13 seconds left on the clock. 3-goal lead for Boston. Make it a 4-goal lead. Make it 5 goals for Dial. Put this one in stone. If they play this well in the playoffs, they are going to be a tough opponent for any team. Certainly were here. Philadelphia. So, yeah, that means, according to DeBeezy, a regulation win, an overtime win, or even an overtime loss. If they can just get it to overtime, that gives them a point. That would be enough to squash the playoff hopes. A good Philadelphia team. Oh, okay, because Toronto has the tiebreaker. Okay. Well, there you have it. Who keeps up with this stuff a lot better than I do. The stats, man. Do appreciate that. Next up, we've got Washington versus Florida. Now, I was wondering if this game was going to happen. Looking at the schedule, and Florida did not. They forfeited both their games on Sunday. And it has been, talk about a tough season. They really had a tough season. Florida. Talented lineup, but has not gone their way. They might have just given up on this thing altogether. Almost couldn't blame them. Here's a few of them joining. Icy is here. Marchie. Yeah, they're going to show up. They'll need to reset things here. And they do. Oh, yeah, it looks like no music tonight. I don't have time to reset all this. I guess I can hum something for you. Instrument in front of me. I can dust off the old harmonic. Oh, yeah. I see is a new edition. Okay. I see is from the NADT. Beezy. I'm getting all this from DeBeezy's credit on the cat. McJabba asked to be dropped for the final two games because he will miss them. Is he the one that's going for his bar exam? I thought I saw something about that on the hockey question mark subreddit. So the NADT, that's been a new addition this season and a welcome one, is a developmental team based on who play in some of the other leagues, the JSL and the RSL. Gives them a chance to play against LHL level teams. Oh, that's Hippo. Okay. I want to make sure. I don't know who all's going for being a lawyer or not. Okay. So, congratulations to Hippo. Best of luck on your bar exam. Jabba is not going to be here for the last couple of games. But I see coming up. Getting the call up from the NADT. See, already developmental team, I should say, starting to pay off some dividends here. That is good. Why it was put together in the first place. So Washington is here. They are here for sure. Go ahead and give you their lineups while we await this one. Taser, D. Ronaldo, Defense with Jerry, Doggone Wolf, and Nargila. I believe I've seen Nargila play on that NFC as well. So, yeah, we're seeing all sorts of new stars coming in. But yeah, it's good for the growth of the game in North America. Good for the continued development. Progression. Of the game in general. Speaking of progression of the game in general, did talk to Cryptic C last week after the Friday Night Hockey. He's usually there for Friday Night Hockey, and he was again. And he let me know that he and Luke are indeed. Want to make sure you get this, naysayers. I'm never working on this again. They are working on Hockey Question Mark. They spent some time working on it just this week, so it is still getting love. And they're right now they're thinking about putting the physics from 55 to. Sure, if they're experimenting with it, might do that, or they might do the newer physics that you're seeing in games like Sub Rose. But there is development. Active development on Hockey Question Mark. For those who have given up hope, I would say don't give up hope just yet, because what the plan is to make, we may not see anything done as far as the 55 branch, the version you're seeing right here, but what they're trying to do is make 62. Oh, the Ronaldo. Shoots and scores for Washington defenseman Jerry on the assist. First goal of the game will go to Washington. But, yeah, what they want to do is make 62 tournament viable. They can get it to where it meets league standards. At some point. Watching LHL in the newer version. Be pretty cool. I know that he has looked at the stuff that people are wanting, taken that list, and those things are being fixed. The things like the glitch goals, the chat bug, and an account system. Confirm that those are all being put in this new version. So I know mixed feelings on that, probably because a lot of people just were like, why can't he fix this one? Because this one is the one we're playing. But if they can make 62 into something that meets the needs of the competitive community, then that's a win for everybody. Really like to push the game a little bit more as an esport, as would we. I mean, certainly is an esport. Zeronaldo puts the biscuit in the basket once again on a beautiful shot to make it 2-0 against this Florida team. Again, long season for Florida continues. But yeah, I took that as great news. I hope y'all do too. I was thrilled to hear it. Hopefully we'll get a new build pretty soon. If we do, we'll certainly be playing it as we have before on Friday Night Hockey. Oh, the shot there, the save, K-bomb, oh, but Zeronaldo swooping in and getting a quick hat trick. They're going to say that's goalie interference. Ooh, it might very well be. May have to pull that one back. I have not even given you the lineups for Florida. The shot here, the save made by K-bomb, of course, K-bomb in the net. They have Icy, Marchie, Evkob, and Tony Flo. Florida. We're going to try to make a game of this here, but already down by 3 as we near the 1 minute mark of the first period. Got to move it out here. Shot from center ice coming in. Big save by Nargila. And he'll get the rebound. Wow.
Nothing but quality.
Yeah. So it's good to see these NADT guys coming up and immediately making an impact. Oh, that almost made an impact as it will land behind the net, mercifully. Tough one for any goalie to stop. And here's a chance. Nope, cleared away. And now Marchie. His shot will be blocked. In the corner. Sent back around. See Ronaldo, but broken up. Oh, Evkob will go for it. 20 seconds left. See if they make a run at the net before time runs out. Got some options here. A nice job of getting through the defense. One deflected slightly. Till the end of the first period. But yeah, don't forget the playoffs start for reals on Friday Night Hockey on the HQML. This Friday was another that was another one we called prematurely because we thought the season was ending, but there was a three-way tie for fourth. Big battle ensued. Who would take that fourth place? Loose is Loose was the team that came away with victory. Teams are all set. So the playoffs will start for HQML this Friday in one. They should be good ones. Then after that will be the finals, and then after that will be another HockeyBots full team exhibition. The last one was hilarious, and they have learned. That the bots are like their own developmental team. And now they're a little bit more accurate and they shoot as well as pass. Talk a lot. important, as you know, if you watch this game. I'll be interested to see how full teams of bots go against each other here. Now, shot, score, taser! Ronaldo with the assist, and Washington, the four-goal lead here against Florida. Their woes continue. Your heart just kind of goes out to this Florida team. So you look at the lineups, and it's like, yeah, they got some beasts on that team. They got some well-known names on them. K-Bomb. That's Ronaldo with his fourth Blake Dials performance in the game we just saw. K-Bomb, one of the all-time great goalies. Facing a lot of uncontested opposition. Dangerous here. They knock this down. Now the backhander coming in blocked. Florida starting to circle the wagons a little bit more on defense. They're down by five. Yeah, it's all you can hope for is just go into the draft and reload and do what you can do. Get some chemistry that works well on the ice. Hope for a better campaign next time around. But hey, at least they showed up to play tonight. Got to give them credit for that. Shot, score, taser. He certainly showed up to play tonight with his second goal of the game. I believe that'll do it, won't it? That reaches the mercy rule in place in LHL. If you get ahead by six, that's game. But, yeah, there's a question, because one of those goals might have been goalie interference. So I think just for sake of ensuring that everything is copacetic, I guess they're going to go ahead and play this out. And that's how they're going to play it out. There it is. Okay. Doggone Wolf will get credit for the assist. And that will put it in the books officially. Washington comes away with the victory. See what? Okay. Next, we've got two games from Edmonton in a row. Toronto first, a game which, as DeBeezy told us, that has playoff implications. All Toronto has to do is, at the very least, take this thing to OT. Then after that, we will see the NADT that we were talking about in action against Edmonton. Play on the ice. Come on. Couple of interesting games here. Not that these last two weren't interesting, but pretty one-sided affairs. It bees that way sometimes. That is hockey. We'll stay on the ice here. There's Nargila getting in on the action. So you get stuck in the net so long, it's nice to shake off the dust and skate as a forward sometimes. You know, when I play goal, they always said that the goalie should be the best skater on the team. I was certainly not the best skater on my team. Knowing that that was hockey proverbs, try a little more to get good. I did my best. Never lost a shutout in shootout. I certainly didn't lose any shutouts because, you know, never lost a shootout. Always very proud of that. So we will await this next game. Kind of open skate right now until the teams show up. Would play music, but still getting an error here? Probably so. At least it's not crackling and staticky. Oh. Oh, back. Very well. But yeah, another season almost in the books here on the Digital Gaming League. And once again, we want to thank the folks at DGL for giving us the time and space to do these. Can't live off of Insurgency alone. More news to come very soon with DGL. Keep saying that. Waiting on them. Spill all the beans. Lots of good things coming for DGL. And remember that you can catch all these games on their YouTube at the Digital Gaming League on YouTube. LHL on DGL. Every Tuesday. For our schedule here, we'll be looking at the playoffs next week. Those will be games 3, 4, and 5. That's the way it usually works. Then the week after that, we will bring you the same 3, 4, and 5, but they will be for the finals. Then we'll keep it going. Here is Ayla and I will do DGO for lovers only. Those are always fun. Scare the normies with some weeb game, visual novel stuff. I have some ideas already. Be afraid, be very afraid that 3 weeks. And we'll get a plug-in real quick for IBN 1 and IBN 2. We are back. And we are in business. Are there every Friday for Friday Night Hockey. We've already told you the schedule of that one. Yeah, we lost IBN 1 for a long time. Thanks to the folks at Twitch TV. Cabal behind the scenes over there. Bring that back to us. Thank them very much. Next game coming up. Where we'd usually play music. Dun, 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 dun. Dun, 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 dun. Time is up. Time is now. Can't see me. My time is now. Okay. Good. We're about to get into it here. Right. As Edmonton takes on Toronto. For Edmonton in blue, it is going to be Crab in a Tree, Fat Squirrel, Big V, Trev Crow, and Dildozer. For Toronto, they will be in red. NHL Killa, Self Plug, KS Auto, Tall Midget, and Briz. Edmonton has already, I guess, punched their ticket to the playoffs. They're in second place right now. Distant second behind Boston, but nevertheless, a second. Toronto looking for the dagger in the heart here, the chance to make their way into the LHL playoffs. An attempt winning the cup. for this season. Again, it's been another great season. While we're thanking people, we definitely want to thank all the folks at LHL, all the players who play, and the people who keep up with it. They've got their own website now. I'll give them a plug. You should definitely check that out. LegendsHockeyLeague.com. Very nicely done. I get a lot of my information about the league from there. So it's informative. It looks cool. It has links to all the streams, too. So wondering where the hell to watch these games. You can just go there and play. It's got the DGL, too. So, oh, yeah, the game's Tuesday night. It's on DGL, right? Okay, I click this. Perhaps some of you might have done that. Good. We welcome you, the millions of people watching. Number one esport in the world, hockey question mark. It is a free-to-play game, and it's made by Cryptic C. Get it at hockeyquestionmark.com. As we told you earlier, development continues for this game, which is, again, that's a testament to the hockey community, because the game is an older game as far as the game world goes. It was pretty dead in North America for a while. It has sprung to life in a major way, and Cryptic C is responding to that and supporting that. A whole new version, 0.55 AI4G. New branch is 0.62. Looks a little different. Feels a little different, trying to make it into something that can pull in some new players but still retains the stuff that made it so great for all the people that put hours and hours into this version. Long pass broken up. In the neutral zone now, race for it. KS Auto is going to take it immediately, blocked off the shot. Way. Here goes Toronto. Very important game. Nice pass across. The shot, the score! KS Auto! And the puck, what's it doing? It's just kind of floating in the air. My goodness.
Hockey question mark, Yule.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. So that'll give them a lead, and now looking for another one here, perhaps. Again, KS Auto with the puck. He'll take this all the way back out to the point with the backhander. That one knocked down in front. Big V. Slide this one across to Dildo. There's a pass to Crab. Way into the corner. We near the 1 minute mark of the first period. Third game of the evening here on LHL on DGL. On front, broken up. Hold on, but again, away. Be Briz. Out of the net. Get it to KS Auto. See where he goes with this. Got a little bit of interference in front, and now the steal, the possible chance. Blocked shot there. Yes. Good defense. That is really one aspect of this game that has improved in the time that I've been keeping up with hockey question mark in North America. Defensively, goaltending, these are two aspects of the game that really, really stepped up in North America. I think these are things that will serve North America well when they play Russia. That's coming up. Very excited about that. We haven't had a good international match in a long time. In fact, some of the newer members of the community may have missed all of those entirely, so this is going to be a lot of fun to see. Also, here's the thing of interest. It will be 5v5, such as what we're seeing here. Now, normally, game is played 4v4 traditionally and overseas. Russians did have a 5v5 tournament a while back. To say how they felt about it, it looked like there were some kind of mixed feelings on how the game played, what they were accustomed to. At some time in, I think the plan is for late May, early June, was the last I heard. When we get confirmation on that, we'll definitely be letting the world know, but happy to know that there's another North America-Russia game. Oh, the moves! My goodness.
Quite impressive, I must say.
Yeah, self-plug. We'll make it 2-0. Or Toronto. This is the kind of game that they hope to have in order to make their way into the playoffs officially. Just to look back for the puck here. They're lined up to try to stop him. Edmonton forming the wall. Toronto pay for it. Here will be Briz. Send this around. All midget there. Up ice. The deflection pass, KS Auto. In his dangerous spot there. Didn't get all of that. We'll maintain the puck here in the zone. It's stolen. Self-plug gets it back. Send this back down. NHL kill awaiting. KS Auto at the point. Immediately swarmed upon. Edmonton will get the clear. Good stuff so far. And, yeah, it's been mostly Toronto's game. Certainly as far as the scoreline, but as far as the pace of the game. Oh, a giveaway. And a chance, and KS Auto is just going to turn the blade. Twist the knife. Make it 3-0. About that. Oh, long shot! Dildozer! From downtown, right off the draw. Much needed goal for Edmonton. Wow. Oh. So that's definitely going to help their chances here, and we're going to need a couple more to catch up. 2 minutes left in the second period. Oh, and here's a chance to shot a big save as he comes out huge in front. That is Fat Squirrel. Talk about somebody who has had a record season. Talking about Fat Squirrel. Has been phenomenal back there. Shows you why. Right there. So Toronto forced to retreat into their own zone, and now with room, we'll take this out. Center ice coming through, save made. Oh, he has to battle him off there as KS Auto was right in his face. Yeah, Fat Squirrel, he gets it done up close. He gets it done far away. So just tremendous. Run out of superlatives to describe the season that Fat Squirrel has put together for this Edmonton team. And you know what? When you get into the playoffs, sometimes riding a hot goalie can really increase your chances. We've seen in all forms of the game. He will definitely be one to watch. Postseason begins. Well, we're talking about the beginning of the postseason. We're ending this period pretty soon, 30 seconds to be exact. And 3-1 it is. KS Auto, though, on the break. Taking the outside and roofing one. The hat trick will make it 4-1. Interesting.
Well, it's always interesting.
Ain't it just. 10 seconds now. Puck loose, neutral zone, possible chance here before time runs out. Oh, he couldn't get all of that, though. We'll just have to be content with a 3-goal lead. Toronto ahead of Edmonton. Start the third period. Strategy?
The pace of the game is really important.
Yeah, I think so. That's been proven over and over, and even in the games that we have witnessed so far tonight. That's just in front of self-plug. Cleared away. NHL Killa and Dildozer will chase this almost to the boards. Tall Midget picking it up. It will go from there. And yeah, we're starting to see some, a little bit of lag on this end. Probably seeing it on the stream as well. The backhander, though, it's not slowing down KS Auto as he gets his fourth of the game. And Fat Squirrel is saying goalie interference on that one. That one may be pulled back. And that's as blatant as it gets. So, yeah, I think we can go ahead and say this one is 4-1. Usually Fat Squirrel isn't going to say anything unless it's particularly egregious. Here's one coming in, easily turned aside. He will try to get it to crab in a tree, just to knock this down with a high stick. Oh, he's going to just send one across the crease. Lucky no one was there. And is he going to leave this? Yeah, he will. And so they'll hold it at the point. Gives him time to come in, grab, blocking the shot. 3 minutes to go. Still, yeah, we're going to go ahead and just say, yeah, that this is still a 3-goal lead. That could change here. NHL Killer! The patience. He just takes his time, gets it right where he wants it on the stick, places it right where he wanted to place it. Oh, it wasn't 5-1, but now it is. Lord Nugget says, there goes Philadelphia's chances. We could have come back from 3, but 4 is just a little much. That's the spirit, man. But here's a chance, the shot, the save made by Briz. Talked a lot about Fat Squirrel, but Briz, quite a goalie himself, and he has preserved that lead for Toronto. And he is one that you will see really step it up in the playoffs as well. Now the stick work. Getting it through off the post, and oh, he was there for the rebound, but not able to slam it home. We'll hang on to the puck here, and he will drop it at the point, but nobody was home. So now Crab trying to bust loose. The whole team swarms on him. Like Adama and Battlestar Galactica. No, we can't take on 3 base storms. We can take on 2 Cylon base. 3. There's a shot. This will go well in front. Right now, they're just playing the possession game, just holding on. Running out the clock. 1 minute, to be exact. And so Toronto is in the playoffs. Simple as. Edmonton, they are already in the playoffs. We may, depending on how the standings shake out, may see these teams in battle again as the playoffs start. But it's been fun to watch, and again, it's not a, we haven't had any close games tonight, but these are the kinds of games that you get towards the end of the season. Some teams are falling by the wayside, and others are trying to sharpen up. This is right when you want your team to be playing at peak performance, right about now. It's going into the play. Full head of steam. So we'll see how Edmonton does in this next game, as, again, we'll be looking at the Stars of Tomorrow, the NADT. Again, a shout-out to Dalfan, and give credit where credit is due. They've put together something really cool, and we've seen the NADT do some great things. Sometimes they get down on themselves, like, didn't catch the one game a couple of weeks ago. I saw other guys say, oh, glad you didn't. It was terrible. But these games, they don't count in the standings, and they are obviously having an impact on how these guys play. And that's how video games work, especially one with a skill curve like this. Get your ass whooped for a while, and then one day you wake up and you look around and you're about 50-50. Suddenly you're doing some of the ass whooping, and then pretty soon you are the ass whooper. That's esports, folks. And this is certainly esports right here. I'm really hoping that the game continues to grow. I have been pleased with how things have gone. We went from having some open skates on a Friday night that we streamed for shits and giggles, and now things have gone into having four North American leagues that are active. That's pretty cool. I think it will continue to grow. Some of the, every once in a while, they'll do a recruitment push and try to get the word out. And in doing so, they've really brought in some really cool people in. Some of y'all I've not gotten to know very well yet. Doesn't help that we're not all on the same team speak anymore, but learning about you through your play. Some of it already, we've seen people that could barely even skate. Now they are starting to get pretty good. We'll see who the NADT brings out tonight. I see you already saw him play for Florida. He'll be on the NADT team, it looks like, tonight again. Or maybe not. Shit, I have no idea. We'll find out when they join. Okay. There's four of them anyway. Legendary Trev. I'm not Stamkos. Capital Skis. Rounding things out. Big Bertha and Omaha. That's a good lineup, right? These are new guys, but they're already making their presence known. I say quote unquote new guys. Oh, Legendary Trev. He is not playing. Will be Dal NADT fan. Dal fan's going to get out there and skate with the kids tonight. And Edmonton. Where'd they all go? They were just here. They just played. Yeah, I see Big V. I see Dildozer. Crab's still here. Ooh, who knows? We may just have a random game tonight. Ah, okay. Yeah, it's looking like it might be a Edmonton forfeit. Like I say, these don't count in the standings. They count long term as far as how the game progresses in North America. The big question, as far as international play, if you're talking about North America versus Russia, who do you play for North America? Oh, okay. Oh, they have a stream for Washington versus Toronto. Okay, so I'll keep streaming this one then. All right. Yeah, because I kind of owe the NADT one because we missed a couple of their games. Okay, so there was a rescheduled game of Washington versus Toronto. Is, yes, being streamed elsewhere, but we will bring you. Okay, now here is Edmonton. Grabbing a tree. Tiggs is here. Big V, Dildozer. Looks like Edmonton will go at him shorthanded. And off the draw, the shot off the post. So Edmonton already taking control here, although, yeah, they're one man down. And some people that have offered to to join in, but they're going to keep the roster strict. You don't want total anarchy and chaos in a DT game. Chance in front! Will get pushed away. Now Dildozer moving through at the line. He'll take this one and it goes over the crossbar. Up to Stamkos. Dildozer will chase this. Goes right behind him. I'm not Stamkos. He'll carry this right in the front of the net. Those are not the kind of plays you'll probably see in the playoffs, but taking a little bit of an extra chance. They're a shorter player. Moved across. Legendary Trev. We'll follow this in for NADTs. Looking up top for Big Bertha. Going to be Dildozer. He's just all over the place. Then one in front. By there to take advantage of that. Has the spot blocked. Now, scramble for the puck. Again, it's on Dildozer's blade. We have called his name a lot already. Dang. They will try to launch some offense. That was a good play there too. I love those kind of passes where you just slam one off the boards, try to just pop it in front of the net. Sometimes that is super effective. We'll see Legendary Trev take it. Stolen. Oh, they're swarming in on the shot. Capital Skis holding firm right there on that corner. Follow-up attempt. Oh, nicely done swatting that one out. All the way back to Big V. Yeah, this one's kind of a more relaxed and loose kind of game. Still seeing some high-level stuff from both of these teams. We're heading close to the one-minute mark of the first period. Still no score. NADT is playing Edmonton here. The second game we've seen Edmonton. Oh, almost off the deflection. The rebound shot off the post. And still in front. Oh, just cannons going off. But nothing over the line. Whole lot of posts getting slapped right there. So NADT with a chance here. Up at the front, Legendary Trev will let this go. Omaha now taking it. Got room and time. Send this through, and again, flicked away, 30 seconds left. He will leave this one for Crab. That he's got three on him. He'll quickly switch this up to the opposite end. Oh, a good job by the NADT. Standing tall at the point. And keeping this one scoreless. Going to the second. So, yeah, as we wind down the end of the season and last few games for NADT, I would have to say that it is an experiment that has been a great success. Just the fact that you had guys coming in and playing on these LHL teams, even tonight, are a part of NADT throughout the season, coming in and being able to make an impact on the game. That's a testament to the fact that it's a very good thing. And now they're hoping to get a goal here as a backhand Legendary Trev. Wow.
Have mercy.
They will take the lead 1-0. And Edmonton, let's see, they do have five now, don't they? Yes. Yes, they do. As Ned Tez here. I don't know if Ned Tez is supposed to be here. He is here nevertheless. We may be bending the rules somewhat as we. Guess this will be the next to last time the NADT will make an appearance this year. Yeah, we hope to see it come back. Sure, there's some guys that are playing in JSL right now that will get their chance to step up next time around. Speaking of successes, I think the JSL has been a success as well. I, I wish I had more time to watch the games or even cast some. We're already doing two hockey games a week. It's very difficult to get to a lot of the RSL and JSL. Both been doing very well and very competitive. And there's a lot of enthusiasm. Yeah, it's good for the game. I like anything that is good for the game. Shout out to all our homies in the RSL and the JSL. We will be seeing very soon here. These games. We are about halfway through this final game of the night. There will be one more regular season game night for LHL. I think that one, I don't know how it will affect the standings or anything. Our playoffs are pretty much set. There may be some wiggle room as far as pairings, the semifinals that are based on those, but somebody else will have to hash that out. I have no idea. Here is Omaha. We'll take this one off the boards to Stamkos. The pass up. Big Bertha on the play. Is going to be Dildozer. Oh, look at the puck handling. But finally taken away. They're going to have a good chance here. Not quite. Oh, man. That is about as close as you can get without a happy ending. Like a bad massage parlor. But we're at the 1 minute mark of the second. NADT does have the lead against an Edmonton team that was shorthanded. Now have five. They are trying to get one on the board here. They've had some opportunities, but that one just off too many bodies. Disappears in traffic. And off the boards is Omaha. Hot blocked, crab in a tree. Capital Skis coming out. Here comes Edmonton in force. And they're going to get through the play and crab in a tree. Penetrating the defense, shooting, scoring, tying this game up at one. How about that?
Incredible is the word that comes to mind.
Yes, maybe slightly credible, but yes. Otherwise, I certainly agree, AIla. Oh, we've had fun casting these games throughout. It is fun to cast LHL. Started doing that a few seasons ago. It has been a blast. We are not done. We'll be back again, don't forget, next Tuesday at this time. To bring you the playoffs.
Playoffs.
Yes. Playoffs.
Playoffs.
We'll save that whole routine for when it is. Finals.
Yes, the finals.
But we still have a period of hockey left to play and a tie game underneath us as... It's been a, even though it's, yeah, it's the pacing is different. It's been a fun game to watch and seeing good things from both sides. Here's BG. Battle with Big V for the puck here. I find Dildozer, Omaha there to prevent that. Oh, behind the net. Oh, a little bit of confusion. BG up to Omaha again. He's going to fire in this one blocked. NADT doing a good job of holding it in, but now here is Edmonton. And they've got him caught going the other way. He will move it in the other direction. Knock the water bottle off the top of the net as Dildozer shoots and scores. 2-1 now the score. Nedtez says that he should get the credit for the assist on that. We'll give it to him, because why not? Why the hell not? And the pass across. Oh! Sweeps right past him. That held in the chip shot. Go over the net, and this could be a playable puck at the faceoff circle. Instead, it is going to be Omaha moving it for NADT. We'll dump this in. In the corner. Set up in front, safe made Capitals. They get another chance at this. Circle around. A good job of keeping the defensive area covered in ADT here. What Capital Skis does, he's just going to go ahead and a wise decision. Going to give his team time to catch this puck, pick it up, and send it through. Here's Omaha. The shot will just go across the crease. Again, we'll watch Dildozer. Taken away in the neutral zone. Quick shot. Off the post. Chance here. The rebound gathered up and swatted home by BGP. I see. On the initial shot there. BGP, we always say. We're not the only ones to say it. Shoot the puck. Crash the net. That's fucking hockey. Good example. Again, BG showing the kids at home how it's done. So we're tied at two. And this has been a good game, and it's getting better here in the third period, minute and a half. Still anybody's to win. Yes, thank you for staying with us, G-Lore. Yeah, you're the only one left. Wow. I guess everybody went to see Washington-Toronto. The joke's on them because they are missing an epic battle here. We'll have to, the millions of viewers that we normally have, we'll have to catch this later on YouTube. See how it turned out. Ah, Dave the Grave is here. Okay, what's up? yes, thank you guys for watching. And there it is again. We were talking about the flipping one off the board trick. That almost paid off again for NADT. It's good to see them using these kind of moves. Putting together a very good game against a team that is, in second place in the league? Fabulous work. Win or lose. This is a good game we're seeing here. Development team. And it looks like three periods may not be enough to decide this unless he gets a shot off in the next few seconds. And now they're going to battle and wind down the clock. And so, some bonus hockey as we go to overtime. Ha-ha. So everybody else left to see some, if the games go like they've gone, it'll be another one of those blowouts by one team or another. Who knows which one. But you, the hardcore viewers, you're getting treated to overtime epic between Edmonton and the North American development team. Next goal wins it. NADT with a chance here and anchoring corner. A little bit of help. One to bend the goal. Here's one coming through. This will go wide. Now, again, we'll see Dildozer get the touch on the puck. He has been very solid throughout this game. Capital Skis will save this and get it out quickly. The dish down to Stamkos. We'll send this around the boards. Followed down. That's good work there. They're getting their positional shit down. There's always somebody right there at the point. Somebody moves up. Somebody else takes their place. Good fundamentals. Good fundamentals. Development. We'll get the puck back here at the blue line. And a good job of moving it. Had a chance in front. Had a guy set up there. Not able to whip that out of the air and into the net. High degree of difficulty on that one. Anyway, this one coming in. Capital Skis. Sees through the screen. Makes the save. One not making its way to the net, but that one does. Everybody chasing this one. Big V. Bob's one. Oh, and Capital Skis gets the angle right on it and makes the stop. This is good stuff. Again, in front, BG with the shot, the save, mate. Oh, it's still on the line, and he clears it away. Grabbing a tree back there in the net. He did not lose his way. He very calmly looked for the puck. Made sure he wasn't knocking it in himself. Here's another chance and another big save. I'll turn this one around very quickly as Tiggs to the puck. Boys in blue will have another chance here. I'm not Stamkos. Puck rolling, gets it down. He'll get to this, and will he have a chance to shoot? No, it just carries him away from a good angle on the shot. Leave this at the point for Omaha. Locked, coming in, grabbing a tree, get the clear. Long pass, I should say. Yes, he had him down there waiting for it. And this one took a similar deflection, but grabbing a tree, plenty of time to see that in. Pop. So the first overtime. Down to a minute here. Long shot. Big save there. Crabbing a tree again. Oh, and almost on the follow-up. But a good block will prevent that. So things starting to get pretty wild at the end of this overtime period. Both teams getting some good looks. Nobody able to seal the deal, and so we're getting, as if we didn't have enough bonus hockey before, we're getting more bonus hockey here. 30 seconds left and a chance for Edmonton. Nice pass. Oh, and they get a little piece of that, just enough to redirect it out of the net. But the chance here, that is wide to the right. So a flurry of shots from Edmonton. But again, staying knotted at two, and we will go to, yes, double overtime. Oh. Ayla, what do you do in an overtime situation like this in terms of strategy?
They are going to have to score goals here.
Yes, a very Madden-esque appraisal of the situation. We've learned that the team that scores the most goals is, generally speaking, the team that comes away with victory. In this case, the next goal is going to be the one that produces victory for one of these two teams. Which is it going to be? Edmonton putting pressure on. Now, we'll have to carry it all the way back into our own zone. NADT playing them very well, taking them to 2-0 here. Again, this is one of the best teams in the league. And the giveaway in front, he's quick to shut that down. And Stamkos, nice play off the wall. This is going to give him a chance for the shot. The save made, though. Grabbing a tree. Been pretty good. Between the pipes. Had to make some good stops here. Keep this overtime going. Now Edmonton, the shot. This will sail over the net. Do hold it in. But a race to get to it. Fling this one around. Loose in the neutral zone. We'll gather it back up again, and then you see NADT again, just all up there on the line. Back checking in. Preventative stance. Puck is cleared. And this has been good all the way through. Quite a game. Especially after watching all these, we saw one Mercy game. We saw your 5-1s and your 6-2s and whatnot. Then we cap it off with a wonderfully close game like this. A great performance from the NADT, but Edmonton, oh! That looked like it was on its way, but looking for the tip, that might have just been enough to carry it out of danger. 2 minutes remain in this second overtime game. And the empty net, I'm not Stamkos, will shoot and score. And the NADT will get a big victory here in our final game tonight on LHL on DGL. They left the net open. That's all I'm not Stamkos needed to see to finish things off here. Anyway, nice victory for the NADT. It's got to lift their spirits a little bit. You'll see more of these guys on LHL teams coming soon. We're already seeing. We saw them tonight. I don't know. If I'm a GM, I'm watching these games closely because the next time the draft comes around, there are going to be some players on this development team that you're not going to want to sleep on. Do some damage. They get in. Don't forget, we'll be back next week at the same time for LHL and DGL as we continue with this season. Watch the playoffs start. That is going to be a lot of fun. It always is. We certainly had fun with you tonight. Thank you, everybody, for watching. We'll see you next time. I'm Winners with the One. I've been here with Ayla. That's another regular season for us in the books. Now the postseason begins. Don't forget, IBN 1 this Friday, HQML playoffs get underway. The oldest cup in the North American hockey community. Blood Dragon Memorial Cup. Who will win it? Somebody has to. Get their name on the Blood Dragon Memorial Cup right there underneath the head of Dwayne The Rock Johnson. Immortalized for eternity is a huge thing, is a traditional thing you will want to watch as history is made on it. Friday night. Follow us on IBN Casting on Twitter. Winners with the One on Twitter. IBN AIla on Twitter. Get her up to 200 followers. Already 175 or something. And thank you all for watching. Whether you're watching this now, appreciate you guys, or you're watching it in the historical documents on YouTube, thank you for continuing to support the streams and the league, and we will see you next time. Good night.
Night, night.